Martha. Jake just mentioned some of those details coming in from the Navy SEALs. You have more as well. We know they landed at Andrews Air Force Base, but beyond that, we don't know much. They're secret again.
They sure are. The SEALs really are giving the most detailed account yet, though, George. And clearly, they were doing almost all of the shooting.
There is no question it was a dangerous and uncertain mission, but not as first described by U.S. officials.
It was a firefight. It was a highly volatile firefight.
It was a firefight going up that compound.
We now know from the SEALs themselves, the firefight ended on the first floor. While the SEALs were working their way through the house after sporadic gunfire, they were connected to one another by a network of radios monitored in Afghanistan by Admiral William McCraven. As the team moved floor to floor, McCraven could hear them shout, "Clear, clear," when each room was deemed safe. When the helicopters lifted off with the body of bin Laden, his 29-year-old wife, shot in the leg trying to protect her husband, was intentionally left behind with her three children, including a 13-year-old daughter who the Pakistani security forces say watched her father killed in front of her eyes. Now, both are cooperating with the Pakistanis, who are refusing to let U.S. investigators see them. Specifically, the U.S. wants to know who visited the compound, where the family had lived before, and the whereabouts of bin Laden's right-hand man, Ayman al-Zawahiri. It was the wife who helped confirm her husband's identity. The SEALs had forgotten to bring a tape measure to size up the famously tall al-Qaeda leader. So instead, one of the SEALs lay down beside the corpse to verify it was approximately 6'4". U.S. officials suspect that Pakistani intelligence had been helping protect bin Laden. They will be checking the treasure trove of intelligence for evidence to see whether that occurred. Hundreds of thumb drives, computers, and cell phones were taken from the compound.
The first priority, seeing if any attacks were being planned, because authorities still believe that bin Laden was giving strategic guidance to al-Qaeda. George?
Hey, Martha, thanks very much. You know, we see this revision of the stories now. At first, it was that Osama bin Laden himself might have been shooting or was resisting. It turns out that he had not been shooting. And now, as you just reported, only one of the bodyguards was really engaged in the firefight. But bottom line, this was still a compound that they didn't know that it could have been filled with bombs for everything, for all they knew.
They really had no idea, George. And just remember, it was dark. It was chaotic. When those SEALs went in there, they knew they were after the most wanted terrorist in the world. When they go through these rooms, they do it methodically. They want to make sure they are safe. They did kill one bodyguard in the beginning, the courier, not really a bodyguard, but four of the people who died were unarmed. But again, there were guns throughout that compound, including in the room where bin Laden was shot.
Right, an AK-47 in the room where bin Laden was shot.
Yes.
Okay, Martha Raddatz, thanks very much.